Hey, what's going on? My name is Derek Mitchell, and in this lesson, I'm going to show you how to use the vanishing point filter in Photoshop. Now, the reason why you might want to use this is, the reason why I'm going to use it right now is actually I want to make something for my portfolio, but I want to make it look like the poster that I designed is actually really on a billboard ad or on the wall, in this case, in the subway. So I'm going to show you how to use the vanishing point tool to achieve that. So let's go ahead and dive in real quick. And what I'm going to do is first show you the old way that I used to work. So I'll throw my graphic in here. I just drag and drop that in from my library of assets that I have. And right now, when you do that, my settings have it set up to automatically have the free transform turned on here. And by default, when I hover over the corner, I get this double black arrow. So on a Mac, if you hold down Command, it'll turn into a white arrow. I'm not sure on a PC, it's probably Control, but if that doesn't work, try hitting some of the other buttons here. Comment below maybe which version worked for you. But what we're trying to do is let it skew by pulling in this corner point. So I'm holding down the Command key still. When I click and drag, now I can move this anchor wherever I want. And you can see how that skews the artwork and makes it look like it's in 3D space. So I'll go ahead and throw this down here on the corner. And I'll throw this image down here on the corner. And this is how I would usually approach quickly throwing something into, say, like the side of a truck to make it look like the logo was on the side of a truck or, again, on a billboard ad or something like that. But where this breaks is once I go to scale this anywhere else in this artwork and I go to scale this down, it doesn't follow the perspective of where it's being placed. So the illusion starts to break because it's not following those vanishing points. So here's how you would do that using the Photoshop vanishing point filter. What I'm going to do is go ahead and hit Command J to jump cut my background layer into a new layer. It's just nice to have a backup in case you mess up. So we've got that extra layer here. I'm going to come up here to filter and I'm going to go down to vanishing point. And by default, it should already be selected, but if it's not, come up here and click on the Create Plane tool or hit the letter C. And I'm just going to click on the corners of this billboard where I'd want to drop in my artwork. And you should see a bunch of blue squares now. If the angle's not quite right, depending on where you dropped it in, it might turn red or yellow. If it's yellow, it means that it'll probably work, but it won't look too realistic. If it's red, it means do it again, it's gonna break. And so once I have this grid here, I can actually scale this all the way out if I wanted to, and I can scale it down if I wanted to. For now, I'm just gonna leave it right here and I'll click OK. And the way that we bring artwork into that grid now, let me show you. I'm going to go ahead and drag and drop this right onto my canvas. I'll scale it down just a little bit. I'll hit return. And now I need to hold down the command key and click right here on the thumbnail or control if you're on a PC. And what that's going to do is actually make a selection right around the artwork. And now I'm going to copy that. I'm going to deselect it and I'll turn off this layer. So now it's actually copied onto the clipboard of my computer, ready to paste into that grid. But before I paste it, I want to make a new layer here. So make sure you've got a new layer to paste it into. And I'm going to come up to filter. I'm going to go back down to vanishing point. And you should still see this vanishing point here. And so with that artwork still copied on my clipboard, I'm just going to paste it right into this vanishing point effect. And it should by default throw it up like this, where it doesn't look like it's in the scene at all. All you got to do is just click and drag and it'll throw it right into that vanishing point grid. And in fact, if we go all the way off grid, it'll still keep it in line with the plane of this artwork. Okay, so once it's in there, I can click and drag to move it around, and you'll notice that it gets masked by that grid that we set up, which is kind of handy. Or if we want to, we can, let me get to where I can see the corner here. I'm gonna click over here on the free transform tool. And if I hold down the shift key while I do that, it'll keep it in proportion without skewing the image, but it'll still make it feel like it belongs in this scene. And that's how you can do this using the vanishing point. So again, the benefit here is if I want to, I can move this down the wall and it still stays in perspective. I'm gonna go ahead and click OK, just to show you what this does on the other end. Now it made a new layer, it skewed the artwork, but you're still gonna run into the same issue. If I go to free transform this or move it down now outside of the filter, it breaks. It doesn't work how you would expect it to. So one more thing I wanna show you before we go is if I jump back into the, let's go ahead and click back on this layer one, come back up here to filter, down to vanishing point, I can modify this grid after the fact. So what I wanna do now, I'm gonna go ahead and make this stretch across the whole wall because I wanna add some graffiti onto this wall. We'll scale it up a little bit. scale it out, and then scale this down. And actually, just I say scale, I'm not really scaling, I'm just adding more grid to it. So I've still got the create plane tool selected, and I'm just dragging these handles down. There we go. All right. So now, if I come back and I again have the, I take that back. I said I had the create planes tool selected. I didn't. I had the edit plane tool. Big difference. Because now we want to have the create plane tool selected, because I can come down here, hold down the option key and click out. And by holding down that option key, it's going to break the plane at a 90 degree angle and add to this. So now I've got this plane on the top wall and it comes down and wraps around on the floor. So here's what we can do with that. I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And I'm going to, let's see, let's go grab some cool graffiti. Is this what I think it is? No, that's not either. I had some really cool graffiti already pulled out and I already lost it. So let's come back here. There it is. This thing. This is kind of cool. So I'm going to copy this image, right click, copy, jump back over into Photoshop. And I'm going to make a new layer. So that way I have a place to paste this into, so it's not working destructively. I don't want to paste it just on top of the other layer. We'll come back to filter, down to vanishing point, and I'm going to paste this artwork in here. And as I click and drag, you can see that it bends right at the floor, which is awesome. So I could make something like, I don't know, paint dripping, or I don't know. There's a lot of really cool ways we could play with this. I should have thought ahead and had a better sample, but you can see how cool that is, that it wraps this around the floor. Let's go ahead and leave it like that. We'll click OK. And now it looks like it bends right there at the floor. Now, obviously, I need to do some more Photoshopping, maybe work with the blend mode, whether it's multiply or probably overlay would give us a better shot at it here. But now you can see how you can use that vanishing point tool to make some pretty realistic artwork that follows along in 3D space here and looks like it really got painted on the floor there. Now, as far as doing some other cool things, like let's add some type to the mix now. Let's say we wanted to add like a vertical, you know, maybe it's in the hallway and it's going to be the section of the subway. So let's go ahead and add something cool like that. Let's just, let me think about this for a second. We want the rectangle tool here. There we go. And let's just call it, oh, let's change the colors on that. I don't want a stroke. We'll make it black. Actually, let's make it red, not the stroke, the fill. There we go. And let's add some text. Let's just call it, what would we call it? Section, how about section 7 or something like that? I don't know. We'll pretend like this is the tunnel and the subway. Okay. So we got our text in there. I'm going to center it and align it to this piece here. All right, so now I'm going to convert this to a smart object so I can edit it later. And then let's go ahead and command and click on it and then copy it. So it copies both section 7 and the ribbon behind it. We'll turn that off. We'll add a new layer and make or deselect that selection there. So now we're working on an empty layer. We've copied this to our clipboard. Let's come back to our filter, back to vanishing point. So that'll still be there. And I'll paste it right into that. Now I can click and drag. And now I can move this anywhere I want to. I'm gonna hit the letter T, which would be my shortcut over here for this free transform. And now, again, holding down the shift key, I can scale this down and put it anywhere on the wall, or I can even rotate it. And when I rotate it, see, this is where my mind melted when I first figured this out. How cool is that? It wraps into our 3D space, so I could scale this down and make it, you know, something cool. Maybe it's like that. That's kind of cool. You know, maybe it goes all the way up and I have to do some masking or, you know, make it look like it fits in the scene. Let's do that. Let's see. Can I scale it this way? There we go. Cool. All right, so click OK, and now that throws that into that 3D space, but you can see we're gonna have to do some masking. So what I'm gonna do real quick is just add a little mask. We're on this layer. I'll click on the little mask icon down here, and now anything that I paint with black on this mask layer is gonna hide what's below it. So I could just hit the letter B to get my brush tool and just start painting away to mask it real quick. I could also hit the letter P to get my pen tool. I'm just gonna click here to here. I'll right click and go to make selection to get those marching ants. I'm on this layer here. I'm going to fill it with black by hitting option delete. So that's one way to kind of knock it back behind the mask. And you can see that if it was truly in the space, it would be kind of dark up here. So we're going to come back and fix that in a second. Let's finish masking our stuff here. I'm going to hit the letter B this time. I'm still on the mask. I'm just going to brush away this real quick. Just trying to show you some multiple ways to work. It doesn't, you know, whatever works in your workflow. Honestly, this is a hard edge, so it actually probably work better if I use the pen tool. But there we go. Make selection. Alt delete. There. Okay. So now that looks like it's really in 3D space, but let's try and sell this a little bit further. So I'm going to double click on this layer and we're going to work on the blend modes here. Let's just kind of play with an experiment a little bit. I'm just going to hold down the option key to split this just a little bit, just a tiny bit, just to kind of, I'm just trying to wash away a little bit of this layer so that way the texture below shows through. All right, and then again, changing blend modes goes a long ways to help. So let's go ahead and cycle through our blend modes real quick and just see what works. And you might have an app, a happy accident. So even though I designed it in red, by using the luminosity version of this, you can see that it actually kind of matches the back a little bit better. So I might leave it like that and play with that. And then the next thing I might do is I'm going to, let's see, let's go ahead and command click on this layer here. Actually, that's not the way I want to work. I'm going to just make a new layer above it. I'm going to get the gradient tool and I'm already painting with black. I'm just going to click and drag down to fill it with black. Then over here in this layer between the two, if I hold on the option key, you can see the icon changes to this little like bent arrow with the square next to it. And what that's going to do is make it so this top layer is being masked by what's beneath it. So if I turn this on and off, you can see that it darkened up right here. So that just kind of helps it feel like it's in that environment a little bit better. Actually, the more I look at this though, we've got some light on that end too. So it actually would probably be more like this. Let's try this real quick. Let's make a new layer. We're gonna mask that down below as well. Let's change it to maybe screen or overlay. We're just gonna play with some different settings here. Screen's probably gonna be our best bet. We'll scrub that down a touch. So that would be my approach in trying to start blending this into the layer. But the key thing I want you to take away is just using that vanishing point and how you can achieve some really cool stuff, especially working with type, flipping it on an end and having it just all the letters skew in the right direction so it actually looks like it's truly in 3D space is something that I think you'll be able to use in a lot of projects. Especially like I said, for me, I'm gonna start Photoshopping in my work, some of the posters that I've done, and make them look like they're really in 3D space. So before we go, one more thing I wanna show you. Here's another version of this. What I'm going to do is bring in another piece of artwork that I've done before. So if you've taken my graphic design bootcamp course, you're familiar with this project. So I'm just going to take a quick screen grab of this poster. And I'm going to jump back over here and paste it in here. And I'm going to scale it up. And now one thing I'm going to do real quick before I actually start applying it in this image, I'm going to go ahead and right click and convert this to a smart object. Now what I can do is do the same thing I did before, and this time instead of using the vanishing point, I'm just gonna use that shortcut where we hold on the command key on a Mac, again, I think it's control on a PC, and I just skew this into place. There we go. Now it looks like it's really sitting on there, but let's push this even further. I'm gonna do the same thing I did in the other one. I'm going to, in this case, I'm gonna command click on this to get a selection. I'm gonna make a new layer above it, get my gradient tool. I'm gonna click and drag from a white to transparent gradient to kind of get a highlight here, and then hit Command D to deselect. Now let's go ahead and I could use the pen tool. I could use an ellipse. So I could come down here and use a rounded or the ellipse tool and get a shape kind of like this. All I'm trying to do is I wanna make it look kind of angled like that. Right click. Make selection. There we go. And I'm going to go ahead and delete away from that shape that I had. And then we're going to scrub this back just a little bit and make it just super subtle. And the whole purpose of this, you've probably seen this, you know, if you actually looked at any of the ads for the iPhone or basically any felon or anything that shows glass or something reflecting. In this case, if this was behind a glass panel, it would kind of have that shine line to it. So that's what that is. And then maybe let's go ahead and darken up the base a little bit. So I'm going to command click on this image again, make a new layer this time down below the shine, and I'm going to swap. I'm going to hit the letter X to swap. So that way my background color, which was black, is now my foreground color. Get my gradient tool, click and drag up. And we're just trying to darken it from the bottom a little bit. I'll maybe change this blend mode to multiply, and let's kind of fade it down just a touch. So now what I can do is as I add this to my portfolio, not only does it look like it's in perspective, you know, vanishing down, you know, using the vanishing point technique. And what I can do now, because I made it a smart object before I did anything else, when it was still a rectangle before I skewed it, what I can do is right click, and I'm going to make a new smart object via copy. And now I can double click in this layer, come back to my artwork, maybe grab a different version. Just grabbing a screenshot real quick. Kind of working lazy. You should probably just export a JPEG, but I'm trying to go fast. So I'll jump back over here into my smart object, paste this in, scale it up, and then make sure you save. So this is layer12.psb. It's my smart object. So I'm going to save this. It's not really saving, you know, anywhere in my desktop per se. But now that updates automatically. And it's tough to see on this version, but that glossy overlay and the shadow down below are still applied to this image. So if I turn off that layer, I have both versions now, and by saving it as a smart object, it automatically applied those transitions to the artwork. So one more thing I want to show you, if you forget and you just copy this layer, I'll just hit Command J to jump cut that to a new layer. Let's say I jump into this, and I'm just going to do something just like this, just to kind of see it real quick, just to see it. And I save this, and I come back into my Photoshop document. Now what's going to happen is both of those smart objects got changed because I forgot to copy it via copy. So that's why if you're going to duplicate smart objects, you want to right click and go new smart object via copy. All right, I hope that made sense, you guys. I am still experimenting with my delivery on my tutorials on YouTube. In the last video I launched last week, we had some comments because I was saying every single shortcut, and this time I was trying to not say as many shortcuts. So again, comment below. I hope you guys love it. I also wanted to show you this extra step with these smart objects, the whole purpose being to speed up your workflow once you've created something, maybe with those vanishing points, or in this case, you know, skewing the artwork, how you can use that to speed up your work so you can do the work one time and then use smart objects to be able to change your artwork really fast. Hey, bonus points real quick. I turned off the recording, but I want to show you one more thing before you go. All right, so I'm going to bring in another graphic real quick. And one thing I want to show you is that, let's go ahead and skew this into place, doing it the fast way here. And if this was really sitting here like this, this light would look like it was reflecting off of this a little bit better. So what I'm going to do is hit Command J to jump cut this. So I've got two of these sitting right on top of each other. I'm going to hit Command L, which is the same as going to image. Well, let's just look at this real quick. Image, adjustments, levels. I'm going to crunch down the output levels. Okay. So let's just crunch this down, and it's going to make it look dark. We'll click OK. And now I'm going to add a mask to this top layer. I'm going to hit the letter G to get my gradient tool, and we're going to do a circular gradient painting with black. I'm going to click and drag down towards the bottom. And now it adds, basically what's going to happen if I turn this off, it just basically hid part of this dark version that's above. So that way it gives the illusion that it's actually light being cast on top of this image. All right, guys, if you like the video, make sure you like it below. Subscribe if you haven't already. Tap the bell so you can be notified when I launch new lessons. Currently, we're going to be launching new videos every Wednesday and Friday. And again, if you have anything you want me to show you in the next videos, make sure you comment below. I definitely will be taking the time to read those. Thanks so much, guys, and we will catch you in the next video.